Police are number one this date in 1981 with Every Little Thing She Does Is Magic. 2002 is next. This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 2 o'clock. This is Nick Qureshi. Ukraine's foreign minister has said the recapture of the city of Kherson shows that invading Russian forces can be defeated in time. Troops have withdrawn from the only regional capital taken since the war began. The former head of Ukraine's National Security Council, Oleksandr Danilyuk, is urging against complacency.
It's a great victory, but we understand that war is not over. Russia will go into deep defense on the left bank. It will put them in quite advantageous position. So the next months will be more difficult.
Allies of the Justice Secretary Dominic Raab have defended his conduct towards staff. The Guardian has reported that civil servants were given the chance to transfer from his department when he returned to the role. Our political correspondent Jonathan Blake has been looking at the allegations.
Various sources have described him as being demeaning and rude and behaving in an aggressive manner, creating what one called a culture of fear. Now, sources close to Dominic Raab reject any accusations of bullying, but in a statement, a spokesperson for him said he has high standards, works hard, and expects a lot from his team as well as from himself.
The US climate envoy has said America will not agree to a fund known as loss and damage, where richer nations would compensate vulnerable developing countries to help them recover from disasters such as flooding. John Kerry said enough aid was already in place. In the US, the Democrats need just one more seat to retain control of the upper chamber of Congress. They're projected to have won the Senate race in Arizona following Tuesday's midterm elections. Professor Christopher Carman from the University of Glasgow says more younger people than ever voted.
What we are seeing is the sort of Gen Z, particularly, you know, the newest voters, are turning out, actually even more so than, say, millennials and women. The issues, of course, that drove that seem to be the issue of abortion access, abortion rights, and then also this sort of broader idea of democracy being on the ballot.
A COVID-hit cruise ship has docked in the Australian city of Sydney. The owners of the Majestic Princess say there are around 800 positive cases on board, with around one in five passengers infected. England's women have suffered heartbreak in the final of the Rugby Union World Cup, losing 34-31 to New Zealand. Despite having a player sent off, the Red Roses led for most of the match in Auckland. Alex Matthews, who's a loose forward, says the team gave it all they had.
I'm just so incredibly proud of the group, putting on that performance, the heart, the desire, the attitude we showed out there. We just did not give up, and I honestly could not be prouder. Win or lose.
And Banksy has unveiled his latest work on a building devastated by shelling in Ukraine. It features a gymnast doing a handstand surrounded by debris in the town of Borodyanka. The street artist has posted the image on Instagram. BBC News, it's 3 minutes past two.
Traffic with Sally.
With the latest travel now. Here's...
Thank you very much, all of you. Very much appreciated. It's very slow southbound approaching the Queensferry Bridge on the M90. I don't know why. I think it's just the volume of traffic heading southbound across the bridge. And the M11 is closed northbound all weekend between 9 and 10, heading up towards Duxford. And in the City of London, it's the Lord Mayor show today, which means that most roads in the city are closed off and not expected to reopen until 4 this afternoon. The M4 is closed between Slough and Windsor, or Slough and Langley, really, 5 and 6 all weekend for roadworks. That's both directions. And in Kent, the A2 is closed westbound between junctions 2 and the M25 and Dartford Heath. And there's a queue on the M25 anti-clockwise from junction 3 to the Dartford Tunnel. And everything actually going towards junction 2 of the M25 is exceptionally busy. That's all the approaches there, including the A2. A303 in Somerset, that's closed both ways between Podimore and Sparkford due to weekend roadworks. And that's all for now. 03 700 100 200 is the traffic hotline number. I'm back with more travel in about an hour. And just to reiterate, the A303 is closed both ways between Bodyboard and Sparkford. That's it. More in an hour.
Across the nation, BBC Radio 2, pick up the pops.
the 12th of November, 2002. A recent number one, down 7 to 22. Pink, just like a pill. Took too